Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a 9070 power supply. I have here an IC697 PWR711 and I've already wired it, so I want to show you what I've done here. If I can get this in front of the camera properly. I have a power cord with white, which is neutral, black, which is hot, or load 1 and load 2, and they're screwed in. The hot wires on the top, load 1, and neutral on the bottom, load 2, or neutral. So make sure that you've got that right. I have the switch in the off position so that when I plug it in, I can turn it on. Now, also in the rack, I've got a IC697 CPX935. It's kind of irrelevant what you have here, as long as you have some sort of a processor, because the idea is you want to make sure that even if the power supply powers up, that it's able to get through the connector to the rest of the rack and power up something in the rack. So we always have this here as a test. The rack I'm using is an IC697 CHS750 five slot rack, which is empty otherwise. So what I'm gonna do is make sure this is in place. And just for your reference, on the other side is just a typical power cord. You've seen both ends now. I'm going to go ahead and plug that in. I have the jumper in place. Very important, make sure that you have the jumper in place. And I'm going to turn it on. First thing I'm going to look for is the LED of the power supply. And then the LED of the CPX. So now I know that power is able to get from the power supply to the rack. That's the more important job. So, if, for example, you turn on your power supply and there's no LED, first thing you want to check, of course, is your fuse. If it's not the fuse, then you have a bad power supply and there's various things that could be wrong. And this is something that we do repair here at PDF Supply. So we do offer repairs, exchange, remanufactured, and new products, and we have same-day shipping. So if that interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.